Hey guys, it's Mariah here, and today I want to be talking about my October growth challenge, and I hope you guys really, really want to follow along and do this journey with me to get my hair or your hair to the goals that you set for yourself. Before we get started, make sure to hit the like button on this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button to show you all the support for my channel, and other than that, just keep on watching. My hair used to be classic length, which was beautiful because it was curly, it was healthy, and it was really, really, really long. And around age, let me say 13, 12 is when it started breaking off. And when it was no longer butt length is when I was like 16, I believe. And I started going on my natural hair journey when I was 17. Yeah. So that just shows you a long way. I will put a picture up, if I could find one, right here of what my hair used to look like and where it is right now currently. And I did cut my hair, so it's a little bit shorter than this picture, but let's just keep going on from there. So I completely forgot that in my remembrance that my hair was even classic length. I just didn't pay much attention to my hair. It was always in two braids. And so before I started my curly hair journey, like when I first started my curly hair journey, I started watching this YouTuber. I'll put a picture up of her channel, and it encouraged me to get my hair back long again. I remember watching the video and then going in the mirror and being like, oh wait, my hair is long too. And then I look in the mirror and my hair was like a little bit shorter than my waist. I could show a picture, the other picture I showed you, my hair was a little bit shorter than my waist, and I was just freaked out. I was like, I need a protective style. So after I realized my hair was at like my waist, I was like, oh my gosh, my goal is to get my hair to my butt, because that's where I thought my hair was. Well, during quarantine, the beginning of quarantine till around April this year, I found old pictures of when I used to live in Canada, and my hair was so long. If I could put like pictures up of how long my hair was or whatever, but my hair was so long and thick, it was beautiful, it was gorgeous, it was classic length. And I was like, oh well, if my goal is to get back to where I was, I'm gonna get back to where I was. So right now my length is at where I thought I was, and it took me around 2 years to get back from like a little bit under waist length to butt length. But I did cut my hair in December to my waist. I cut it to my waist. So it took me 11 months to go from waist length to butt length, where I am now. And I'm still not even at classic length. So I'm really hoping that next year I could get to classic length, or throughout these months, because my hair is growing pretty quick. But yeah. Anyway, so I made this challenge to kind of help us get there a little bit faster and without having to wear your hair in protective styles, because I've been consistently kind of wearing my hair out. What I've noticed is that I can't consistently keep my hair in a protective style, because when I don't do the proper care for my hair, it breaks. I also have what's called chronic touch your hair syndrome, so I'm like always in my hair, but I always try to treat it really, really nice. This October, when I reverted my hair back curly, I did trim it straight across so it was even. I don't know how even it is, I really don't, but it felt even. And I decided to really focus on getting my hair to classic length even more. I put it in protective styles maybe 2 weeks out of a month, but that's pretty much it. I just love my hair out. I want to enjoy it while it's growing to the length that I want it to get to. So for this growth challenge, it is pretty simple, it's pretty plain. In the first 2 weeks I've been doing it, it's worked. So, I'm just getting into the rules really quick. So, the first thing that I decided to do is I did not want to shampoo my hair. And I heard from a bunch of stylists that shampooing your hair less is really, really good for hair growth. So, I canceled out shampooing my hair, and this meant that I couldn't do hot oil treatments because I can't necessarily rinse it out of my hair. So that is the one thing that I decided to do. I shampooed my hair at the beginning of the month, and I'm gonna leave it alone. Another thing that I decided to do was 5-minute scalp massages every single day. I have missed a couple of days, but for the most part, I've been sticking to doing it every day. Well, almost every day. Another thing is I finger detangle. So once a week on Sunday, I finger detangle with a very slippery conditioner in five sections, my hair in five sections. And it worked out very, very quick, very, very well. Better than detangling in the shower for hours, actually. So that is amazing. So finger detangle with your favorite conditioner that's very slippery. And yeah, another thing we will be doing is incorporating oils to grow our hair. We will massage our scalp with these oils and put them on our hair, make sure it stays moisturized throughout the week. We will be rinsing our hair with water once a week on Sunday. It's like a wash, but with nothing. So I just rinse my hair and kind of finger detangle under the shower head by just separating my curls. I don't break. I just separate to kind of restore the thickness back to my hair that I want. And lastly, make sure you are taking some sort of vitamins to help boost your hair growth. I take biotin, I take MSM, I take echinacea for immune system 2, I take iron, I take zinc, but I take zinc for acne, magnesium, I take a bunch of stuff, and vitamin C. So I take a lot, and it's for internally being well, and also my hair, because it's benefiting my hair growth. For the most part, my hair had a boost of hair growth ever since since May, and I've been taking this since May. So yeah, another thing that I wanted to say is I make sure to leave my hair stretched. So I use the Revair to stretch my hair, and I personally did go on to one of the Revair's live streams, and I asked if stretching your curly hair with the Revair once a week will I eventually get heat damage and so forth, and they informed me that I will not. So I'm taking their word for it, and I haven't received any damage. This is my stretched hair right now. You see my curl pattern is very loose, and yeah, my hair is kind of webbed together, but it's mostly detangled. Like, I could separate it. That is pretty much it, and I will show a picture of what my hair looks like with me stretching it now, roughly. So yeah, this is my little growth routine, and I really hope you guys show me your results. Text me on Instagram, because I'm always there, and we could grow our hair to our goals together. Please comment down below and tell me what your hair goals are and what you want in your hair, because I just have one goal. I just want to reach classic length, and then after that, I'm gonna bluntly cut my hair to a little bit above classic length. So like maybe around mid-butt length, or a little bit longer than that. But that is just my hair goal. And I'm gonna do everything I can to get there. And I hope me and you can get there together. Anyways, thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoy. I really hope you guys accept this challenge and do it with me. And other than that, peace out.